Nelson Cotton, Varsity Sports Network, talking to Calvert Hall coach Donald Davis after winning, beating Royal in the Turkey Bowl. His ninth time in the last 10 years, tying on himself in the Calvert Hall streak in this amazing series. What does that mean to you?
It's a blessing just to be a part of the series, to have the opportunity to play in it. And coaching it is unique, something that we can share with the Baltimore community. It feels weird you even mentioning my name with Augie Maselli, because he is, he's the best. So, I'm just proud to be the steward of the program right now. And, I pray that I'm doing the right thing for the school and the right things for our kids. And I try to do the best job I can. So, I'm prayerful. That I'll continue to be able to do that. Our kids have just done a fantastic job, so I'm proud of them.
August's grandson got a couple catches today.
Augustine did a nice job today. So Augie 3, man, he got his opportunity, and that's what we talk about all the time. We tell our kids, man, whenever you get your opportunity, you just take full advantage of it, and he did. And I'm proud of him. He's a great kid. He's a great teammate. And those are things you want. That's part of what makes a great team, is you have young men in the locker room that care about each other and that care about what we're doing, what we're trying to accomplish. And that's when you win. When you win, when those kids are in your locker room.
A lot of people doubt it, man. What's he doing playing a game? You guys played Sterling on Saturday. Turn around short. I think you knew what you were doing.
I don't know whether I know what I'm doing or not. What I do know is I coach as good a group of kids as there is around. And I trust them. I trust their ability to get up every day and come out and compete every day. And we look at one extra game as just another day to compete. And that's sort of our daily mantra. We come in and compete. We chop wood every day. So, I know that our guys will come in and prepare themselves, whether it's a long week or a short week or a bye week. So they've done it all year. I had no reason to believe they would do otherwise.
Cole Herbert today, he was covered on it. He goes up and gets it, and Amir puts the ball in the line. Talk about that combination.
First of all, the best part about that combination is we get it back next year.
That's a good point.
So to have those guys beginning to grow some chemistry, obviously Cole had tremendous chemistry with Mike Campbell. So for Amir to come in and those guys to be able to begin to build a rapport, I've said it before, Cole Herbert is as good a wide receiver as there is in this area. There are several really good ones this year, but he's among that group. So his ability to run routes, get himself open, win the football against coverage. As you said, Loyola's kids did a great job of covering him.
They did.
He just won the football.
Yeah.
So for him to be able to do that, and Amir to be able to put it in spots, give him a chance to make plays, it's great. I'm fortunate to be able to coach those guys.
Was there any point in time when you thought the game was in hand at all?
At the end.
Maybe when Calvert Hall came back in. Loyola scored.
Yeah, we went back down and scored.
Yeah,
looked really good. So, I anticipated that. Coach Day, even those guys do a great job. I knew we would get their best shot coming out of halftime. So they held, frustrated us on offense a little bit. And then they went down and put in the score. And our kids answered. For us to be able to, come back, put together a nice drive, go down and score again to keep the distance where it was. At that point in the second half, it becomes purely mathematical. At that point, they really begin to run out of time. So for us, and I know how good our defense is. So, at that point, I started to believe that, hey, we've sort of got this thing in hand. If we're smart about managing the football down the stretch, we can come away.
Yeah, you played a lot of kids.
We did. We were, with the exception of our JV kids, we played some of them. We played every single guy on our roster.
Really?
We just didn't get every single JV kid in.
That's awesome.
But we played all of the varsity guys that have been up all year, got an opportunity to play at least one play today. And that was one of the things that I'm proud of. All of our guys got an opportunity to feel and experience being out there playing against Loyola on Thanksgiving Day.
And that's something that we're going to do.
Indeed.
12 wins in a season, school record.
Yeah.
What does it mean? Also, is this your best team?
My guys, my former guys would kill me if I say that. Let me tell you, I said early in the year when we played Wise that this might be the best defensive line we've ever had. I probably got four phone calls the next day from guys on our defensive line from that, you know, that 2009, 2010, 2011 group. But, you know, here's the thing. Those guys were amazing. They finished number one in the state. But this group won 12 games this year. You know, we took the field 13 times, we won 12. And that's just tremendous. So if they're not the best team I've ever coached, they get the opportunity to say they've won more games than anybody else.
Right, right.
And what I can say is I've had as much fun coaching these guys this year as I've ever had coaching. They were just a fun group to be around every single day. Mm-hmm. And it took me back to some of those teams in 09, 2010, 2011, 2012. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there's some characters in the locker room, but there's great cohesion within our kids. And I believe that's part of why we were successful in some of the tight games and why we were able to come back in games. Like, we were down to Spalding, able to come back, tight games against Wise, able to come back and win those games. I think because of the, you know, the spirit, the camaraderie that exists in our locker room between our kids.
Fantastic. All right. Congratulations, Coach. Man.